let's continue our introduction to OpenMP in small bytes. My name is Christian Terboven from RWTH Aachen University. In this rather short video, I will continue the discussion of tasking, now with a focus on task synchronization. But first, let's review the barrier. I mentioned that there are implicit and explicit barriers in OpenMP. A barrier that is implicit is part of the end of a work sharing construct and can be omitted with a so-called no wait clause. You can also put an explicit barrier in your code, like shown for C and C++ here on this slide. What does a barrier mean with respect to threads? It's like a full stop synchronization. So that means any thread of the team can only then pass an OpenMP barrier if all threads of the team have reached the barrier. That does not mean that all threads will immediately start after the barrier or continue the execution after the barrier. However, that's possible, but it in fact depends on the operating system. But a barrier requires all threads to wait for all the others. With respect to tasking, that means in addition that all tasks that have been generated before the barrier have to be completed before any thread is allowed to continue after the barrier. That means all tasks are completed, and that also means that threads that reach the barrier will start looking for any tasks that are not yet in execution. So for example, they might still be in the task queue, and the threads will take a look for them and bring them to the execution. And we discussed that previously. In many task parallel programs, you will find that there's only one thread that is generating the task, while all the other threads will sooner or later reach a barrier and then wait for task generation to happen and then pick up those tasks for execution. This is not the only tasking execution model in OpenMP, but it's very popular when there's recursive algorithms or a single executor pattern where a single thread is, for example, iterating a loop and generating tasks. But there are more task synchronization constructs in OpenMP. The first one is the so-called task wait directive, the first one that I want to take a closer look here. It's a standalone directive, and as I think I said before, in the context of, for example, Fibonacci code, a task wait waits for the completion of direct child tasks of the task encountering the task wait construct. It really waits only for direct children, yeah? Not all descendant tasks. It includes an implicit task scheduling point. That means this is a point where the current task or thread might suspend the execution of its current task and switch to another task. So let me illustrate what's going on here. We have a parallel region with a single. So one thread executes the body of the single. This one creates a task, which then consists of two more tasks and a task wait. As I said before, this task wait construct will wait only for the completion of this and that task, not any possible children. If we refer to this task as A, the task wait will wait for B and C, but not for any other tasks C1, C2, and so forth that C or respectively B might create. As I said, the task wait will wait for only direct children. The other task synchronization construct of interest is the so-called task group directive. It enables deeper task synchronization because it will wait for the completion of all tasks and their descendants that have been generated in the extent, the dynamic extent of the task group construct. And there's a task scheduling point at the end, meaning a point at which a given thread can switch the execution of tasks. It also accepts some clauses, a reduction clause, and I believe we will come back to that later on. But let me make the remark here at this point already. If you want to implement reductions with tasks, then you need, for example, a task group construct and put the reduction clause at the task group construct, because then it gives you, or gives a runtime, a well-defined point at which the task reduction can be executed. Here I would like to illustrate the difference with respect to synchronization to the task await construct. So as I said, the task group waits for all tasks that are generated in the dynamic extent of the construct, which includes the B and C tasks, but also the C1 and C2 tasks that might be, or in this illustration, are created as part of the execution of the task C. And that would also correspond for any task created by B or any further task created by C1 and C2 and so forth. So it's a deep task synchronization. Now let me again take a look at when there are tasks created, how many of those, and when it's guaranteed that tasks are being completed. So we have a parallel region that will consist of a team of in total NP threads. Each thread encounters a task construct, so that means NP tasks will be created here, one by each thread. So remember, tasks are not work sharing constructs, so that means each task that is encountered will imply the generation of a task that may or may not be deferred. So that means function A will be executed NP times, possibly by different threads, but also possibly by the same thread, because the threads may defer the execution of the task. Then we have a barrier. Threads are only allowed to pass a barrier after all tasks have been completed. So that means function A will have been executed NP times before the barrier may be passed by any of the threads in the team. Now we have a single construct, which I refer to as a single inspector pattern. Yeah, so that means one thread will execute the body of the single and may execute this task, but it might also defer the execution of this task for another thread. But here, because there's only one thread, only one task will be executed. Function B will only be executed once. And the execution of the task, the completion of the task, and in consequence, the execution of the function B will be guaranteed after the end of the single construct, because single is a work sharing construct and contains a barrier at its end.